work, work that body, Tracy.
Well, no, you to do a bit of exercise.
It would hurt a lot.
Yeah, well, you know what they say? No pain, no gain.
Yeah, well, I think I'll wait for the Mr. Blobby workout. He don't go for the burn, he goes for the melt. Talking of burning, either your tracksuit is about to burst into flames, or you've knackered the porridge.
Oh, no!
No oats for you today, then?
No, no, some of it's all right. Do you fancy a bit?
Oh, not all. No, not porridge. I'll leave the porridge to Chris.
That cereal's already got added sugar.
Yeah, I know. Just added it. Ooh, piggies, piggies, piggies.
Well, let's have a shifty.
After me, you're first.
Oh, that poor girl. It says here, the Princess of Wales is finding it so hard to lead a private life, she's been forced to seek a house far away from such favoured royal counties as Berkshire and Gloucestershire. Sources close to the Princess...
Because she never leaves home without a bottle of ketchup.
..say a move to the West Indies or the south of France can't be ruled out.
Oh, the pity of it. She must be distraught.
It ain't easy being a royal, you know.
I'd swap.
Yeah, well, you wouldn't like it.
Oh, of course not. All those film premieres, designer dresses, holidays around the world. And, of course, I'd really miss scraping the burnt bits off the griddle.
Yes, look at the strain being royal puts on your marriage.
Oh, yeah. Must be worse than having a husband banged up for a 12 stretch.
You know what I mean. There she is, a woman in her prime, probably the most beautiful woman in the world.
If not the universe.
And yet, her husband is cold, aloof and unfaithful.
Oh, be fair. Charles ain't that bad.
Oh, and you'd know, of course.
Yes, I like to think I know something about substandard husbands. At least I never found another bird's knickers in the glove box of the royal coach.
Sharon, why have you taken all these pictures of fry-ups? What is it, pornography for fat people?
No, I thought I'd have them blown up and hung in the window. Entice passing trade.
Yeah, entice them to keep passing.
Don't you think I've captured the character of the mixed grill? The golden smile of the egg. The beefy bravado of the burger. The cheeky confidence of the kidneys.
Cobblers.
Butcher swore they were kidneys.
Privacy.
I don't think mixed grills are that sensitive, Trace.
I mean Diana. I mean, at least when you're ordinary, you don't have to worry about people prying into your personal life and taking secret photos of your working out. What the bloody hell's this?
It's a secret photo of you working out.
I never gave permission.
Oh, calm down. I'm your sister, not the Daily Mirror. I think they're brilliant pictures. Look how I've captured the way your hair goes all lanky when you're sweating like a pig.
Take these.
Last week, when you were going raving mad on Daryl's Nautilus machine, I just happened to have the camera with me.
Yes, well, I'll have these, and I'll have the negatives and all. Thank you very much.
You won't believe what has just been poked through my letterbox.
Well, I've never heard you call it that before.
The new owners of Faden Lodge want to buy 20 feet of my back garden so they can build a sports complex. They've offered us £5,000.
No, the swines.
And please, do they think I am going to tolerate all that disruption, dirt and noise just for the price of a couple of Chanel suits?
Well, of course not. I mean, what would you want with half a dozen muscular, tattooed, half-naked builders straining away at the bottom of your garden?
Oh, I hadn't thought. No, I'm sorry. That is not the point. I mean, what sort of person builds a sports complex in their grounds? No, it can only mean that Faden Lodge has been bought by some vulgar, semi-literate sports personality like Frank Gascoigne or Paul Bruno. The negative impact on property values would make £5,000 look like chicken soup.
All right, keep your hair extensions on. I just wish someone had insulted me to the tune of five big ones.
If they'd offered Dor five big ones, she'd have accepted.
Hang about. Show!
20 foot off of us and all.
No, that's fantastic!
Oh, I don't believe it. Talk about timing. There's such a lot needs doing round the house. I mean, the sofa's completely knackered since Garth and his girlfriend celebrated passing their catering exams all over it.
I don't think it's that simple, Tracy.
What isn't?
Well, much as I hate to be the bearer of sad tidings...
Since when?
I rather suspect that the new owners will want both our gardens, or neither.
Oh, yeah. Of course.
Sorry, Tracy, but...
Sorry? You don't know the meaning of the word, you selfish cow.
Don't be trying to sweet talk her, shall?
£5,000? What I can't do with my half of £5,000?
Excuse me, did I miss something? Where did your half come from?
Oh, I'm sorry. Of course I was forgetting. This is your house and I'm just a lodger.
Well, not to put too fine a point on it, yes.
And for just 1 minute there, I was starting to feel as if I belonged. As if this was actually my home.
Oh, stop bickering, you two. Neither of you is getting any money. Because Marcus and I aren't going to have our garden turned into some gymnasium for some muscle-bound half-wit.
But, Dorf, for all we know, Faden Lodge could have been bought by someone quite upmarket. You know, like Steve Davis or someone like that.
Oh, suddenly I'm weak at the knees.
Well, can't we go and have a butcher's at them? You might be pleasantly surprised.
Yeah, after all, I was only reading a minute ago how Princess Di is looking for somewhere to live.
Do you really believe that royalty would move to Chigwell?
Well, they might if they knew Dorian Green lived here.
Ladies, what can we do for you?
Just come to say hello.
That's very considerate of you. Hello.
We just live round the corner.
And we thought we'd pop round and introduce ourselves.
And be good neighbours.
Her husband's the neighbourhood watch coordinator.
Well, thank you, but watching the neighbourhood's our job. 24 hours a day.
Oh.
Maybe it is Diana.
No, he's much too tall.
We may have to find a new wine bar, girls. I seem to have sucked this one dry.
To coin a phrase.
Never mind all that. Did you speak to Marcus about the garden?
You did tell him it was Diana.
Yes, but he remained rock solid. Something of a rarity for Marcus these days. Anyway, to make up for it, let me buy the drinks tonight.
Oh, that's real compensation, that is. 2,000 pina coladas and we'll be quits.
My usual, please, ma'am.
Hold on, don't you recognise him? That's the bloke from Faden Lodge. You know, the neighbourhood watcher.
Oh, of course it is.
Well, that's no reason not to befriend him, is it?
Yeah. I'll tell you, mate. It's the kids I feel sorry for. I mean, little Harry, he's too young to understand yet his parents are not going to get it back together again. But William's old enough to take it really bad.
Yeah, but last time I was driving him, Charles reckoned to me he still loves her.
Well, what's he doing back with that married bit then?
Dunno, maybe it's just, you know, platonic.
Oh, you what?
Well, I couldn't fancy it. Got a face like a slate layer's nail bag. What about, you know, all the money he's spending on this house, that indoor sports centre he's building for her? That ain't going to leave him much change out of, what, half a million?
Yeah, well, he can afford it, can't he? I mean, the whole family's loaded.
Yes.
It's not as if he pays a lot of tax now, is it?
Yeah, I suppose you're right. Hey, do you fancy another half?
No, mate, we've got to go. She's got that film premiere tonight.
I would have wet myself.
I wish they had gone a minute ago. That's it, isn't it? You've got to sell them your bit of the garden now. Not to would be tantamount to treason.
Yes, but we don't know it's the same, Charles and Diana.
Don't be an egg. With kids called William and Harry, with 24-hour protection, what more proof do you want?
Yes, well, I would like to see them with my own eyes.
And how are we going to do that? With Wolf and Trojan minding the gate? We've got to get rid of this, Trace. Everywhere I sit, I've got a spring up me, Harris.
Maybe Dorian will buy it then.
feel weird getting dressed before dinner on a Sunday.
Yeah, well, if it is nice, you'll take the boys to church. Their dad insists on it.
What's she like? I want to be a Sloane.
Yeah, this is how she dresses when she doesn't believe it's Di.
What do you mean? I just wore the first things that came to hand.
Oh, what's up? Even for you, you're walking funny.
You ain't caught something off that carpet fitter, have you?
Just seems to be something wrong with these Wellingtons.
You soppy mare. You haven't cut the bit of string that's holding it together.
Surprised you weren't panicking, doll. Must be the longest your knees have been together since.
I don't know why I keep coming round here to get insulted.
Oh, well, it's so convenient, isn't it?
Oh, come on.
You haven't been out and bought this specially?
No, I borrowed it from the garage, you know, to test it.
Oh, well, yeah. What's the back seat like then?
Time to get it authentically muddy first.
Well, what do you think of the car?
It's hard to tell, Dawn. We've only come 500 yards.
It's very me, though, isn't it? I always felt I needed a four-wheel drive.
Yeah, to negotiate the perilous north face of the Waitrose car park.
No, it's very safe, you see. You're very high up. You can look down on other drivers.
You look down on other drivers, whatever you're in.
No, aren't you?
What are?
The gates!
Belt up, Sharon!
I said nothing.
Well, I can't see them.
You shouldn't have let them get away from you at that crossroad.
She was doing 110. For her, but if I get stopped doing that speed, I can't tell the police you can't book me, you work for my mother-in-law.
Okay, there's a church up there, maybe that's where they've gone.
You expect me to get this up there?
That's the sort of challenge you usually relish.
I feel like I've been comprehensively rogered. You'll be keeping the car then.
No sign of the royal jam jar.
Well, they could be in the church. We should go in and check.
I ain't exactly dressed for church.
Me neither. You'll have to go, Dawn. No, sorry, not church. Not when it's functioning.
Vicar won't bite you. Well, that's no encouragement, Trace. The vicar will bite you, Dawn. All over.
Oh, shut up.
Look.
Come on, let's go.
Still warm.
So?
I saw Columbo do it once.
Yeah, what does it prove?
He had cold hands. Follow me.
There she is.
There.
Right. All we have to do now is
find the exit and wait.
What? You mean you don't want to go?
Well, my stomach
hit me ring up on the coconut shower.
I've never heard you talk Jane Austen before, Sharon.
Oh, she went in for technicolour yawns and all, did she?
Hello again, ladies.
Oh, hello. What a coincidence.
Yeah, that's just what I was thinking. You were waiting for anybody?
We're just waiting for our turn.
Because we're all dying for a go.
Especially Sharon.
Well, we'll give you a hand then, girls.
No, that's all right. We'd jump in the queue, wouldn't it?
No, it's all right. We know the governor. Adam, you don't mind if our three friends here push in, do you?
No, that's all right.
Oh, it's all right, there you go.
I'll leave it, thanks, and I have a sleep.
No, you're all right.
I ain't there. Real daredevils, these three, Adam. I've seen them drive. Well, boys, you enjoy that?
Yeah.
Go on, there you go.
It's so! Isn't it amazing? Whatever you eat, it comes back as diced carrots.
But I don't see how I could accept their money, Tracy. It would mean putting a price on the physical and moral upbringing of a future King of England. No, if Harry and Wills need a sports complex...
Hold on, Dor. If you give them your bit of garden for nothing, then I can Tracy...
Did you hear something, Tracy?
Eh?
Sorry, just thought I heard something. A sort of unpleasant, low animal sound.
Lock it off, Dor. Oh, no.
Probably the wind. Yes, must have been the wind.
Look, I've said I'm sorry, and it's no big deal.
No big deal? That sweater was 3-ply cashmere. If you were dismembered and your component organs sold for transplantation, they would not amount to the cost of that sweater.
You ain't really trying to tell us that no one's ever been sick on you before in your life. You can't have been on a works outing.
Sharon, shut it.
Yes, well, it's a little late for that now, Tracy.
Cheer up, Dor. You're going to have royalty as neighbours. We've seen her with our own eyes. Just think what it'll do for property values when you can say you live in Royal Chigwell.
Royal Chigwell. Oh, yes, exploited properly, this could catapult me to the top of Essex society. Not that I am that far off the top now, of course. I could ask her to become a patron of my charity.
What charity?
Well, I don't know. I'll start one.
Slag Aid?
She will need new advisers, you know, friends, a mature head on an incredibly well-preserved body. I could become a lady-in-waiting.
Oh, yeah. First lady of the bedchamber.
I wonder if there'll be anything for me.
Sorry?
You know, in the royal household.
Oh, yes, Sharon. First lady of the sick bucket.
Just think, we're going to be sharing a postcode with a future Queen of England. Here, what do I call her? Ma'am? Your Majesty? Your Royal Highness?
Oh, I wouldn't worry, Sharon. The chances of you running into her while rummaging in the outsize box at the Sue Ryder shop are slim to the point of anorexia.
Yes, but what if I'm mowing the lawn and she's hanging out the washing and she sees...
I don't believe you, Sharon. Yesterday it was all put the royal parasites up against the wall.
But that was before I knew we were going to be neighbours. Here! We could go down Bubbles together. She'd have her pick at a bloke, so I could have what's left.
Sharon, calm down.
I could throw a dinner party for her. You know, invite a few local worthies. Some of Marcus's business associates. Immediate family. Members of the International Press Corps. Harper's, Tatler, Vogue, Hello. News at 10, Frost on Sunday, Beatles about. What?
Has it ever occurred to you that Princess Diana might be moving to Chigwell for a bit of privacy?
You're looking good. Oh, is that a new muscle I can feel?
Yeah, I think that's an old muscle I can feel.
Sorry, it's got a mind of its own. Better sit down.
Here. Been doing a bit of working out down the gym.
Oh, very tasty. Oh, I like this one. Your leotards are wet in this one.
They're all.
Do you mind if I keep them?
Of course not.
Because I can get 5 snout for each of these.
Oi!
Only joking.
Maybe this will take your mind off Nookie.
Actually, I doubt it. You'll never get... Sorry, you first.
No, after you. Have you got some news?
Sure.
Yep.
OK. Do you ever hear of Chas Savage?
I don't think so.
Of course you have. Charlie Savage. Savage by name, Savage by nature. He did the Big Wolves job back in 82.
What did he do? Nick all the pick and mix?
No. He only hacked into their payroll computer to the tune of 9.5 million.
What, and now he's in here?
No. He never caught him. He spent the last decade sunning himself on a Copacabana and trying to avoid Ronnie Biggs.
Why?
Well, wouldn't you?
So why is a 12-year-old robbery such big news?
Well, you would never guess who's just bought a house.
I don't know where rich blaggers live in Brazil.
Chigwell.
You're not trying to tell me that they've got a Chigwell in Rio?
Tracy. See, his wife, Dinah, started getting homesick for England, and as Charlie was carrying on with some married Brazilian piece...
The girl from Ipanema?
I doubt it. Word is she got a face like a slate layer's nail bag.
Hang about. Charles and Dinah?
Yeah, funny, isn't it? What makes it even more ridiculous is that they've based their whole marriage on you-know-who. She's dyed her hair, had it cut like Princess Di, had the nose job. They've even called their two lads William and Harry. Although William could be called after Charlie's uncle, Wild Billy Savage, the Deptford slasher.
They've just moved into Thaden Lodge.
And they've just moved into Thaden Lodge. Oh, you've already met her, have you?
Tried to, but there's a couple of very tasty types minding the door.
Don't worry about all that. When Charlie heard we was neighbours, he made me promise you'd befriend her.
Oh, what, your pen pals?
No, but he keeps in touch indirectly. He's got a cousin in here.
A con?
No, assistant governor. Anyhow, I promised him you'd give her a ring, make yourself known, be nice to her. I've got the number.
All right. Just get a pen. Here. OK.
So, what was your big news?
Garth and his bird have knackered the sofa.
That's my boy.
I could get a job at Chigwell School as a dinner lady. Give the little princes double oven chips and they'll tell their mum how great I am and she'll offer me a job as her cook.
Brilliant scheme, Sharon. Shouldn't take more than a decade to come to fruition.
Well, it's better than your idea. Divorcing Marcus and marrying one of her minders. Trace! Trace, it's definitely her! Dorian followed him on the way to school. The boys are going to Chigwell Prep.
I did not follow her. We just happened to be going the same way.
Well, did you speak to her?
No, she was 50 yards ahead of me. Anyway, what could I say?
Well, could have compared engagement rings.
Wouldn't want to humiliate the woman.
Did you tell Daryl the news?
Yeah, he was really chuffed. Said I've got to ring her up right away and invite her round for a cup of tea.
Oh, yes. Phone her up. Just like that. Hello, Your Highness. This is your common neighbour. Just popping a couple of savoury pancakes into the microwave.
Yes, well, don't you think it'd be a nice gesture? You know, neighbourly.
And I suppose he knows her personal phone number.
No, only the editor of The Sun knows that.
Oh, I thought it might be the same number as old Mrs. Leggett had when she used to live there. You never know.
Very likely.
Well, it won't hurt to try, will it? Hello, is that Di? This is Tracy Stubbs. We're neighbours over the back fence. That's right, you want to buy a bit of my garden? No, of course I don't mind. In fact, we've been trying to introduce ourselves, but your two gorillas didn't seem to like the idea.
How can she talk to her like that?
No, of course not. Anyway, I was just wondering if you was at a loose end, if you fancy popping round for a cup of tea and a savoury pancake. Today? Oh, lovely. Yeah, that'd be fine. OK, then. See you in, what, half an hour? Right. Lovely. Bye. Should be round in half an hour.
Neither do I. Honestly, Tracy. I mean, a joke is a joke. But if you expect us to believe that in 30 short minutes we will be meeting the Princess of Wales...
I don't care what you believe, Dor. But if it is Princess Diana and you ain't here, you're enough gonna feel a plank.
Tracy, doing?
Catching up on a bit of work. What's it look like I'm doing?
Yes, well, aren't you going to change? You cannot wear jeans for royalty.
Oh, so you believe she's royalty now?
Yes, I believe she's royalty. I just don't believe she's coming here with you wearing jeans.
She wears jeans?
Yes, well, she can wear what she likes.
Yes, well, this is my house and I can wear what I like. Anyway, it's only the woman from over the back fence coming round for a savoury pancake and a cup of tea. And anyway, it's her that wants the favour.
What favour?
You and Tracy have both got 20 foot of backyard she needs.
You may have backyard. I have professionally landscaped Japanese-influenced rock garden.
Yes, we've still got it and she still wants it. And don't go mouthing off about giving it away.
Trace! Trace, she's here! You've got to go and greet her on the step like they do at the Royal Writing Performance.
Too late! My God, what a social gaffe! Leaving a princess standing on the doorstep!
Sharon, you go and answer it while she signs this.
I can't go! The excitement will go to my stomach! I ain't shaved my legs or nothing!
Tracy, she'll leave!
It's a letter from you to me to say you agree to sell your garden to her, not give it away, mind.
It's all right, all right.
Thank you.
Hello again.
Hello.
Woman.
Hello, I'm Tracy Stubbs. This is my sister Sharon, and this is Dorian Green, our neighbourhood snob.
Pleased to meet you. Yeah, don't take the piss, girls. It's not my fault I'm a dead ringer for the Princess of Wales. Here, Trace, could you tell us where the little girl's room is? Because I'm bursting for a leak.
Just at the top of the stairs.
Tar.
So much for the royal we.
Thank you.